Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to get better knowledge search results in Ivanti Service Desk. First, we're going to take a look at two configuration choices, excluded words and selecting the objects and attributes to search. And then we'll take a look at some suggestions drawn from my many, many years of experience in technical communication for how to improve the content of your knowledge articles themselves. When Service Desk searches for knowledge, it searches for all of the words in the search phrase, except for a set of excluded English words. If your users enter searches in other languages, we recommend you add the localized versions of these words to the excluded words list. Similarly, you want to exclude words that would make the search algorithm think it is finding useful information when maybe it isn't. For example, if your company manufactures guitars, and you use the knowledge base to search for issues about guitars, you actually might want to add the word guitar to your excluded words list. Most of the searches will be about guitars, so including this word in the search string won't help to narrow down the search. It will find all articles, including the word guitar, and think, that could be useful. You want the results of a question about guitar strings to focus on articles about guitar strings, and not on articles about guitar cases, guitar pickups, and so on. I put a link in the description to the page in the help that discusses the excluded words list. Using the object designer in Service Desk, you can specify which objects and then which attributes on those objects you want to include in a knowledge search. Your instinct may be to include everything. If the information is in there, I want to find it, so let's search everywhere. However, this isn't the best approach. A much better approach could be to just include the title and keywords attributes of the article object in the knowledge management module. Let me explain why, and then you may choose to tweak this suggestion to make it better suit your requirements. If you are searching for the answer to a technical question, the best results list isn't pages and pages of possible solutions, but is just a single item that actually gives you the answer you're looking for. This may not be achievable, but it's kind of what we want to aim for. If you include incident resolutions in your knowledge search, you're going to get a lot of unhelpful and duplicate results. Sure, there are nuggets of useful information in there, but it is much better practice to convert those useful resolutions into knowledge articles that will then appear towards the top of a search list, rather than have them buried in the middle of a huge list of garbage. And don't include large pieces of text, such as the article resolution itself, in the search, because again, you'll include lots of duplicate text that may not help to identify the article you require. For example, if you include the article resolution in your search, and then a user searches for set up an email server, they will find articles that include the phrase, before you start, set up the email server, or even, you do not need to set up the email server before you do this, and so on. By searching only on the title and keywords, the user will find only articles where setting up the email server is central to the article. Now let's think about the article titles. They are included in our search, so they need to include words and phrases that you think the user will search for. But don't get too carried away, because the titles are also what the user will see in the results list. And when they see the results list, they will scan down the page looking for the title of the article that looks like it will answer their question. So keep this in mind and make sure the title accurately identifies the purpose of the article. When you have settled on a title that will correctly identify its contents, add other words and phrases that the user may search for as keywords. In particular, try to think of the alternative words that users may use. For example, some people call the thing that you're looking at now a screen, whereas others call it a monitor or a display. These are prime candidates for keywords. They don't need to go in the title because the users will recognize the alternatives, but they need to be found by the search. For the article itself, try to keep it as short as possible and don't include unnecessary information, jargon they may not understand, or complicated language. Users will be daunted by overly long articles. If you do need a long article, use subheadings to help users to scan for the section they really want. And when you have completed your article, read it to yourself, as if you were reading it aloud to someone. This will help you to spot places where it doesn't flow, where you've missed words, copied and pasted something and then forgotten to edit it, and so on. I hope you found this video useful, and you'll be able to use some of the ideas to improve your Service Desk knowledge base. If you want to see more videos like this about all our products, remember to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.